And welcome back. Well, we like to hear from the group Common Ground here on the show on Wednesdays, but because we are going to Boo at the Zoo live tomorrow, we are going to connect with Common Ground today.
Common Ground is a group of farm women who want to be a resource for consumers who want to know more about how their food is grown. Join us now to talk more about Nebraska farms and how many are family farms is Carol Swan. Nice to see you, Carol.
Well, it's good to be here.
Yeah, good morning.
Even on a different day, I'll
there
be confused the rest of the week.
I know, that's right.
You set your calendar by this
yeah.
week. So how's everything going in your area?
Very good. Oh, everybody's really harvesting, really running hard. I don't know, they probably start at 6-ish, and I don't know when they get done.
Mm-hmm. Where do you live from, York?
I live south and west of town, between town and the interchange.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, cool. Well, we want to talk about the harvest season because I know it's a very busy time, and a lot of families are working together. So how many Nebraska farms are still family farms, would you say?
I don't specifically have a number, but say 97% of all the farms in Nebraska would be considered family farms, so that would leave 3% that might be corporate farms. Uh-huh. So it's, and nationwide, it's 93%. Our family farms.
Okay. They've just changed. Maybe the dynamic of them has changed because I know when I grew up, my dad and my grandpa farmed together, but the farms weren't as big as they are today.
Yeah, there's many acres, but it's still the similar dynamics. You know, some of them have as many as, you know, have three generations. You've got your kids coming up, your, like, the middle son and then the grandparents, you know, grandparents and onto the son and then mm-hmm. onto the next generation. So there's like two or three generations in a lot of them. And you're right, they are big. They're big because they've absorbed, with the expenses of equipment, they can farm a lot of ground with, you know, not a very amount of time and a lot more economically than, say, one farmer having a set of equipment for a half section of ground. They can have lots, you know, same equipment but and farm a lot because mm-hmm. it's bigger. Yeah.
Carol, is it like in, you know, I think the old days when, you know, everybody worked together on the farm to get that harvest in? Is it that way still
today? It's still that way. It's just higher technology, bigger equipment. But the emotions, the family relationships, everything that you had to have then, you had to trust each other, you had to respect each other, you had to communicate with each other, it's still vitally important. Mm-hmm. Because if you don't, you lose some things. So the relationships you have the spouses, you have people, some people that work off the farm, some people that work off the farm but then they get off work of their job and they hit the mm-hmm. field. So you have all these different dynamics, different relationships. And one of my things was, you know, they have production, they have marketing, they have finances, they have human resources, and they have to take care of this all at the kitchen table. It's just like any big corporation, but it's a family. And the family, they work together, they play together, they do school functions together, and if things kind of can go south maybe during the day, they still have to come together and you know, communicate, maybe apologize, maybe get things figured out for the next day because they have to forge ahead. It's the family farm, and families will do anything. You know, it's their very soul. It's their livelihood. It's their life. It's their very soul. Family farmers will do almost anything to keep it functioning, keep it going, keep things running smoothly. Mm-hmm. And harvest is like, oh, they got a combine driver. You know, somebody's got to drive the combine. Somebody's got to drive the grain cart. Two or three truck drivers. Somebody's doing fall tillage. Somebody might be shredding stock. Somebody else might be running the baler. So there's a lot of family members or extended family members. I know some people, like family members that are extended family that are off farm, they'll plan their vacations and they'll come help out.
Mm-hmm. Come back to help.
Yeah, they'll come back and
it's
help.
It's interesting you say that, how things can go south.
Yeah.
Because we would use that old corn picker.
Mm-hmm.
And so we'd have the ear corn and we'd put in a corn crib. Uh-huh. And I remember my grandpa and my grandma getting into some discussions.
Yeah.
You know, but then everything comes together again.
Yeah. Because you got to remember, your family, it's loved ones. The relationships are important because you chose these folks. You know, you can't, like you say, you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family. But yes, you can choose your family because, you know, you chose maybe your spouse. Maybe your spouse wasn't all that involved. They saw the fun times of the farm, and then they get married into it, and then they kind of say, oh, my gosh, mm-hmm. this is different.
Yeah.
So it's really important, the dynamics, mm-hmm. the trust, the communication is so key, mm-hmm. so key. It's, and I'm fortunate to, like, kind of in close with my tenants. I see their communication ability mm-hmm. and how they're all patient and how they all work together. to get everything done, and that's just so important. Good news, bad news. Mm-hmm. It's got to be brought up.
Right. It's interesting everything time comes, of year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is.
Okay,
yeah.
Carol, thank you, and you're staying around.
Yes, I am.
We want to have Carol stick around. Yeah, we're excited about that because she's going to be talking about a fall craft idea or some fall decorating.
Yeah, Carol, you kind of get crafty when you come here on the show.
I was on the shredder, and I had a lot of time to-